Welcome to a lesson on the sorted edges algorithm that can be used to try to find the optimal or lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. So as an alternative, our next approach will step back and look at the big picture. We determine a Hamiltonian circuit by selecting edges with the least weight and then fill in the gaps as needed. And here are the steps for the sorted edges algorithm, also known as the cheapest link algorithm. Step one, we select the cheapest unused edge in the graph. Step two, we repeat step one, adding the cheapest unused edge to the circuit, unless A, adding the edge would create a circuit that doesn't contain all vertices, or B, adding the edge would give a vertex degree 3. Step three, repeat until a circuit containing all vertices is formed. So in our past several lessons, we found the Hamiltonian circuits of the given graph here, where using the brute force algorithm, we found the circuit ABCEDA with a total weight of 19, which we knew was the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. Then we applied the nearest neighbor algorithm and found the Hamiltonian circuit AEDCBA that had a total weight of 21. And then in our last lesson, we applied the repeated nearest neighbor algorithm and found the circuit ABCEDA with a total weight of 19. We begin by selecting the cheapest edge, which would be edge DE. And now we select the next cheapest edge as long as it doesn't violate condition A or B. But notice how in this case, edge EA and edge EC both have a weight of 2. Which means when we apply the sorted edges algorithm, we may actually end up with two circuits. Let's first take a look at the circuit that would include edge EA. And just to remind ourselves, we'll have to perform this algorithm a second time. Notice how this circuit would contain DEA. And if we used edge EC, the circuit would contain DEC. So we'll find this circuit first and then come back and find the second. Now we want to select the next cheapest edge as long as adding the edge would not create a circuit that doesn't contain all vertices, or adding the edge would give a vertex degree 3. Notice how the next cheapest edge would be edge EC, but we can't use this edge because that would give vertex E degree 3. So the next cheapest edge would be edge EB with a weight of 3, but again we can't use this edge because this again would give vertex E degree 3. So the next cheapest edge would be edge AD with a weight of 4. We also can't use edge AD because this would create a circuit that doesn't contain all vertices. So finally, the next cheapest edge would be edge AB with a weight of 5. The next cheapest edge would be edge CD with a weight of 6. And finally, edge BC with a weight of 7 to form our Hamiltonian circuit. So if we start at vertex D, we would have DEA, B, C, D, with a total weight of 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6, which is 21. Now let's go back and find the second possible circuit. Again, we know we're going to start with edge E, D. But now instead of using edge EA, we'll use edge EC that has the same weight of 2 for our next choice. The next cheapest edge would be edge EA. We can't use that because it gives vertex E degree 3. The same with edge EB. So the next cheapest edge would be edge AD with a weight of 4. The next cheapest edge would be edge AB with a weight of 5. And then finally edge BC with a weight of 7. So again, starting with vertex D, we'd have the circuit DEC, BAD. With a total weight of 1 plus 2 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4. Which is 19. So of course we'd So of course we would use the circuit with the least weight, the second circuit here. But looking back at the directions, it does ask us to give the circuit starting with vertex A. So let's go ahead and rewrite this. We'd actually write the circuit starting at A as A, D, then vertex E, C, B, A. We could also give this in the reverse order as a duplicate circuit as A, B, C, E, D, A. So if we add this to our chart, notice how the sorted edge algorithm did give us the optimal or lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. But we should recognize this may not always be the case. Let's take a look at one more example. We begin by selecting the cheapest edge, or the edge with the least weight, which should be edge AC with a weight of 3. The next cheapest edge would be edge BC with a weight of 4. The next cheapest edge would be edge AD with a weight of 5. The next cheapest edge would be edge BD, which we cannot use because it would create a circuit that doesn't contain all vertices. So we can't use edge BD. So we'll next consider edge AB with a weight of 7. Again, we cannot use that either because once again, it will form a circuit that doesn't contain all vertices. So the next cheapest edge would be edge BE with a weight of 9, which we can use. Notice how there are no vertices where these edges cross. The next cheapest edge would be edge AE with a weight of 10, which we cannot use because notice how this would give vertex A degree 3. So the next cheapest edge would be edge CE with a weight of 12, which again we cannot use because that would give vertex C degree 3. The next cheapest edge would be edge DE with a weight of 14, which does complete our circuit. So again, if we list the circuit starting at vertex A, we'll go from A to C to B to E, to D, and finally back to A. So again, we'd have A, C, B, E, D, A. And now let's find the weight. That would be 3 plus 4 plus 9 plus 14 plus 5. Which is 35. And we should also recognize there would be a duplicate circuit in the reverse order. We could give the same circuit as ADE BCA. I did have one more example, but I think we're short on time, so we'll stop here. I hope you found this helpful.